In that day, the Lord with his sore and great and strong sword shall punish Leviathan the piercing serpent, even Leviathan that crooked serpent. And he shall slay the dragon that is in the sea.
Demonic oppression do not have the final say in your life, Israelites. The Most High is giving you in-depth knowledge to deliver you from oppression. If you know how to battle the invisible enemies, your life in the physical realm will improve. Israelites, you have to familiarize yourself with the enemy behind the scene. Your enemies behind the scenes are spirits. The Most High has been infusing into your mind to focus on the unseen, while the kingdom of darkness want you to focus on the seen things.
For we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen. For the things which are seen are temporal, but the things which are not seen are eternal.
For as long as I've been alive, Israelites have been targeting the enemies we see in the physical realm. We have been fighting racism and discrimination with a carnal mind, unjust laws by trying to get a seat at the table, marching in the streets to bring awareness to our oppression, holding hands with the same people whom the kingdom of darkness is using to oppress us. Multiple generations later, we are in the same position. We are battling the same problems in every generation. We uplift people who are popular with the world and reject our people who do not fit into our physical appearance criteria. Israelites are quick to reject what they do not understand. Our ancestors chose King Saul, the Israelites' first king, based on his appearance. In addition, they wanted to be like the other nations.
All the elders of Israel gathered themselves together and came to Samuel unto Ramah, and said unto him, Behold, thou art old, and thy sons walk not in thy ways. Now make us a king to judge us like all the nations.
The Most High warned his people of the suffering they would face if they set a man over them. Our ancestors disregard the Most High and request to have a king just like the other nations. Fast forward to today, our people are rejecting the solutions the Most High gave to his people to survive. They rather use the solutions of this world to overcome oppression. Our ancestors rejected the Most High as their leader when they request to have a man be king over them.
And the Lord said unto Samuel, Hearken unto the voice of the people in all that they say unto thee. But they have not rejected thee, but they have rejected me, that I should not reign over them.
When are we going to believe our Elohim and reject the kingdom of darkness? The moment a person like myself give a new solution to the problems that have been plaguing our community, this generation will not give an ear to hear. They rather side with the same people who have been aiding in their destruction, repeating the sins of our ancestors. This generation wants to resolve the problems plaguing our people independently of the Most High. Israelites rather place a heathen over them than to submit to the Most High. They believe a heathen can deliver them. As the result of our rebellion, the enemies behind the scenes continue to oppress our people. This generation continue to go around in circles, just like in the days of our ancestors when they entered the wilderness.
For the children of Israel walked 40 years in the wilderness, till all the people that were men of war, which came out of Egypt, were consumed, because they obeyed not the voice of the Lord, unto whom the Lord sware that he would not show them the land, which the Lord sware unto their fathers that he would give us, a land that floweth with milk and honey.
Our ancestors were wandering the wilderness for 40 years. It was not until they realized they cannot succeed without the Most High. In addition, when the generation that rise up against the Most High died, the Israelites were delivered and was able to inherit the land the Most High promised them. This generation has been wandering for 400 years. When our people get tired of wandering, they will have no choice but to face the invisible enemy that has been the root to their problems for all these years. Discrimination and racism are spirits. Oppression is a spirit as well. These invisible enemies have been working behind the scenes to keep you stagnant as a people. In addition, keep you from connecting to the power that is within. The kingdom of darkness want you to focus on the people that are carrying out the racism, discrimination, and oppression. The more you focus on the flesh, the stronger the oppression the kingdom of darkness place on your life will be. Until you focus on the root, you will remain defeated. How did the Most High say you would defeat any spirit?
Submit yourselves, therefore, to God. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you.
When you obey the Most High by following his instructions, you will begin to see your personal deliverance. You have to cry out to the Most High. It is the Most High that will deliver you. If you continue to boycott your enemy's establishments, reject knowledge, and take matters into your own hands, you will remain in bondage. You must humble yourself and seek the Most High.
The God of my rock, in him will I trust. He is my shield and the horn of my salvation, my high tower and my refuge, my savior. Thou savest me from violence. I will call on the Lord, who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from mine enemies.
The prophets the Most High used in a significant way had no problem crying out to the Most High. King David seeked the Most High with all of his heart and mind. In addition, David made it a habit to pray and fast. He knew the power he would receive from praying and fasting. Samuel, Moses, and the righteous prophets of old had to seek the Most High to be delivered. Even Yeshua relied on the Most High to protect and deliver him from his enemies.
Thinkst thou that I cannot now pray to my Father, and he shall presently give me more than 12 legions of angels?
This generation of Israelites believe if they educate their oppressors, then their enemies will accept them and stop discriminating against them. Israelites, your enemies know exactly who you are. The kingdom of darkness know who you are. You are now discovering your identity and the power that dwells in you. Your enemies do not fear you for no reason. The spiritual wickedness in high places, the so-called elites of this world, know the greatness that dwell in you. The kingdom of darkness control the rest of the population and they are unaware. That is how the kingdom of darkness programmed them to fear and to hate you. Low vibrating people in all races are puppets to the kingdom of darkness. They are being tossed back and forth. The scripture said many are on the broad road that leads to destruction.
Enter ye in at the straight gate, for wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction, and many there be which go in thereat.
The Most High is doing what he prophesied he would do. In the last days, knowledge would increase. In addition, he would pour out his spirit on his people, and they would dream dreams. Because of the awakening, a small minority of strangers are beginning to see what was hidden. They are starting to realize they were lied to. Just like how we are finding out who we are. Attacking the flesh will not solve the problem. It is important to shift your focus to the unseen oppressor. Attacking the seen thing is a temporary fix. You have to attack the invisible enemy behind the scene. The invisible enemy live in the spirit realm. Defeat your enemy in the spirit realm and you will defeat your enemy in the physical realm. Israelites, as long as you are giving the kingdom of darkness an opportunity to oppress you, they will accept your offer. Sin opens the door to the kingdom of darkness. It is your responsibility to maintain your deliverance. When the same spirit is repeatedly seeking to forge a covenant, the Most High is revealing two things to you. The old covenant that was giving the unclean spirit permission to oppress you has been broken. You were delivered from the hold the unclean spirit had on your life. For example, if the spirit of poverty is tormenting you in the spirit realm, the spirit of poverty is looking to establish a covenant. The spirit of poverty do not want you to know the old covenant was broken. The unclean spirit keeps attacking you, hoping that you will give up. Israelites, it is important that you never give up. You must continue to bind the devil until it flee from you. If the spirit of poverty or any spirit had a legitimate covenant, that spirit would not continue to seek to forge a covenant. A good strategy the kingdom of darkness use is to keep you ignorant of their presence in your life. Satan do not want you to know the kingdom of darkness is the root to your problems. Satan wants you to place the blame on a person, the flesh. Unclean spirits wants to live undetected in your life. Once their presence is revealed, you will evict them out of your life. In order to carry out their will in the physical realm, they need you. Another reason unclean spirits continue to torment you in the realm of the spirit, the Most High is revealing to you unresolved sins in your life. There is an area in your life you are falling short in. The door is open, giving unclean spirits access to torment you. Before you engage in spiritual warfare, you have to make sure you are in good standing with the Most High. Any iniquity in your life would delay your deliverance. If you seek to battle the kingdom of darkness while you are in sin, you will be defeated. There are many instances in the scriptures where our ancestors attacked their enemies. They were defeated because of unresolved sins in their camps.
Israel hath sinned, and they have also transgressed my covenant which I commanded them. But they have even taken of the accursed thing, and have also stolen, and dissembled also, and they have put it even among their own stuff. Therefore the children of Israel could not stand before their enemies, but turned their backs before their enemies, because they were accursed. Neither will I be with you any more, except ye destroy the accursed from among you.
You have to deal with the sin first. Once you repent by turning from the sin, then you can engage in spiritual warfare battle. Israelites, fasting and praying is not the first step in attacking your oppressors. Fasting and prayer is used when you are on the battlefield. The first step is to close the door that is giving the kingdom of darkness access. Second, know what you want the Most High to do for you. Third, you go to battle by praying and fasting. Many Israelites jump straight to prayer and fasting and get defeated every time they seek deliverance. The Most High is an Elohim of order. Remember, sins separate you from the Most High.
But your iniquities have separated between you and your God, and your sins have hid his face from you, that he will not hear.
Not too many Israelites are familiar with marine spirits or water spirits. The marine world is the largest division in Satan's kingdom. Marine spirits are one of our biggest oppressors. Witches and warlocks love to use marine powers to oppress their victims. Many of the problems we face today stems from the water spirits. Israelites, marine spirits are extremely stubborn. You would have to engage in multiple spiritual warfare battles to be delivered from these spirits. Once you understand how these spirits manifest in the physical realm, you will understand how diabolical and stubborn they are. Not too many people believe marine spirits exist because Disney has desensitized the people from these spirits. Disney made you believe these spirits are fairy tales. Israelites, marine spirits are very real. The workers of iniquity frequently use marine spirits to torment their victims. There are countless dreams revealing marine spirits are seeking a covenant. Dreams where you are by the water or in the water is symbolizing marine spirits. Tsunami waves and floods symbolize marine spirits. If you are swimming in a pool or dirty water, that is symbolizing marine spirits. If you are being attacked by an alligator, snakes, and any animal from the waters, that is symbolizing marine spirits. Sexual dreams are marine spirits. If you find yourself having multiple sexual dreams in a week, the Most High is revealing you have a spirit spouse. Many people have spirit spouse. Marine spirits are the culprit. A spirit wife or husband are very selfish. They will see to it that you never get married in the physical realm. If you get married, they will oppress your marriage until you get a divorce. A spirit spouse would even go as far as killing your earthly husband or wife. Israelites, you do not want to play with marine spirits. They are diabolical. Read the book of Tobit in the Apocrypha. Spirit children will oppress your earthly children and cause you to be barren. To those of you who have the witchcraft spirit oppressing your bloodline, workers of iniquity in your household or a family who seek a worker of iniquity would sacrifice their children to marine spirits. The workers of iniquity can sacrifice their entire bloodline to marine spirits. By doing this, generational curses would plague your family. Some of the patterns to look for, all the males in the family are promiscuous and never get married. The women in the family are beautiful, but nobody wants to marry them. The family is plagued with teenage pregnancy and pedophilia. There are countless other patterns revealing marine spirits are the root. There are many other dreams revealing marine spirits is seeking a covenant. Once they achieve the covenant, the marine spirit began to oppress the victim in the physical realm. In the physical realm, the marine spirits manifest itself in multiple ways. Sexual perversion opens the door to these spirits. When you engage in masturbation, lustful thoughts, and fornication, marine spirits are the root to these sinful acts. By engaging in these activities opens the door to the marine spirits. We all have seen how homosexuality have taken over certain nations all over the world. Marine spirits are the invisible enemy behind these plagues. Nothing happened by chance or a new trend. The kingdom of darkness are the force behind the children of disobedience. Many people believe they are controlling their life. The truth is, unclean spirits are controlling their life. Israelites, as you mature spiritually, you will begin to see how the words of the Most High manifest in the physical realm. Unclean spirits cannot oppress a person unless they obtain permission. We often hear people who are oppressed by marine spirits say they have felt this way since they were a child. Most of the people in the alphabet community reveal marine spirits have been oppressing them since their childhood. If their parents were aware that unclean spirits are the reason for the abominable changes in their children, I am hoping they would rebuke the unclean spirits. However, too many parents are unaware of the spirit realm. This confirms how the kingdom of darkness controls low-vibrating people. The parents are helping the kingdom of darkness destroy their children. I find it interesting the heathens have laws that states minors under a certain age require adult supervision. A minor cannot operate a motor vehicle until they reach the minimum age. There are strict laws determining when a person is able to give consent. However, children as young as 2 years old can start transitioning and mutilating their bodies. How? Make it make sense. Israelites, the kingdom of darkness attacked the youth at a young age to secure its reign in the next generation. The spiritual wickedness in high places enforced the kingdom of darkness agenda by attacking those who do not support the kingdom of darkness. This is why the scriptures say we wrestle not against flesh and blood.
For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places.
Some people in the alphabet community were abused sexually as a child. This opens the door to marine spirits. Marine spirits influence people in many ways. Sexual perversion is not the only way marine spirits manifest in the physical realm. When you wear provocative clothing, you attract marine spirits. Taking vulgar pictures are influenced by marine spirits. Many of the things you see in pop culture are influenced by marine spirits. Israelites, your enemy behind the scenes are dangerous. Most people would not associate an unclean spirit dictating their everyday life. The kingdom of darkness have a way of making you believe the demonic thoughts were your own thoughts. For example, a person find pleasure in cutting himself or herself. That is an unclean spirit causing that person to do that. Nobody in their right mind would cut themselves. The longer the unclean spirit has been in your life, the more of a hold it has over your life. That is how many people spiral out of control. It is important to attack the invisible oppressor behind the scene. Attacking the flesh will not help. The unclean spirit will find another vessel to oppress you. Many people are influenced by marine spirits and other spirits. They have no idea. The next time you hear someone say he or she was born in the wrong body, having the desire to wear provocative clothing, believing that he or she have a high sex drive, just remember that is a marine spirit saying these things and pushing you to act on those thoughts. The kingdom of darkness is looking to steal, kill, and destroy.
The thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. I am come that they might have life, and that they might have it more abundantly.
Israelites, you have to learn to differentiate what is from the Most High and what is coming from the kingdom of darkness. Satan did not become the god of this world by luck. The kingdom of darkness observe and study their victims. In addition, understand the laws of the Most High that govern his creation. It is your responsibility to understand the spirit realm and the physical realm. When you understand how both realms operate, no weapon that is formed against you shall prosper. The Most High is with his people that walk uprightly. Israelites, get to know the Most High, all aspects of him. By doing this, you will rule the world you live in.
But now thus saith the Lord that created thee, O Jacob, and he that formed thee, O Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed thee, I have called thee by thy name, thou art mine. When thou passest through the waters, I will be with thee, and through the rivers they shall not overflow thee. When thou walkest through the fire, thou shalt not be burned, neither shall the flame kindle upon thee. For I am the Lord thy God, the Holy One of Israel, thy Savior. I gave Egypt for thy ransom, Ethiopia and Seba for thee. Since thou wast precious in my sight, thou hast been honorable, and I have loved thee. Therefore will I give men for thee, and people for thy life.